Hello there. Merry Christmas. Are you cold? Come on, come closer and get comfortable. The fire is warm. Hey, have you ever heard a story of how the Grinch stole Christmas? No? You haven't? Well, today's your lucky day, because today I'm going to tell you a story of how the Grinch stole the Christmas.
Every hoedown in Whoville liked Christmas a lot, but the Grinch who lived just north of Whoville did not. The Grinch hated Christmas the whole Christmas season. Now, please don't ask why. No one quite knows the reason. It could be, perhaps, that his shoes were too tight. It could be that his head wasn't screwed on just right. But I think that the most likely reason of all may have been that his heart was two sizes too small.
I hate Christmas. Yuck. Do you hear me, Max? I hate Christmas.
I kinda like it, rough.
Staring down from his cave with a sour, grinching frown at the warm lighted windows below in their lovely hood town.
And they're hanging their sad stockings. Max, my dear, Tomorrow's Christmas. It's almost here.
Then he growled with his Grinch fingers nervously drumming and thought he must find some way to keep Christmas from coming. For tomorrow, he knew all the Who girls and boys will wake bright and early. They'll rush for their toys. And then, the noise. There is one thing the Grinch hates. The noise. Then the Whos, young and old, will sit down to a feast. They'll feast on Who pudding and rare Who roast beef.
Here, the brown turkey's ready.
Yes. And they'll feast. And they'll feast. And they'll do something he hates most of all. Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small,
they'll stand close together with Christmas bells ringing. They'll stand hand in hand, and those will start singing.
And they sing, 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 sing!
Jingle bells, jingle all the way. All the fun is to ride along the way.
Hey, hey!
Jingle bells, jingle all the way.
And the more the Grinch thought of this Who Christmas sing, the more the Grinch thought that he must stop this whole thing.
Why for 53 years I put up with this? I must stop Christmas from coming, but how?
Then he got an idea. The Grinch got a wonderful, awful idea. He knew just what to do. The Grinch laughed in his throat. He make a quick Santa Claus hat and a coat.
What a great Grinchy trick. With this coat and with this hat, I'll look like just like St. Nick.
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are. You're as cuddly as the cat is. You're as charming as a Mr. Grinch. You're or a bad banana with a reasonable
stop barking!
All he needed was a reindeer. The Grinch looked around. But since reindeer are scared, there was none to be found. Did that stop the Grinch? Ha! The Grinch simply said,
if I can't find the reindeer, I'll make one instead.
Uh-oh.
So he took his dog, Max, and he took some black thread, and he tied a big horn on top of his head. Then he grabbed some bags and some old empty sacks on the ramshackle sleigh, and he whistled for Max. The Grinch said, "Giddy up!" And the sleigh started down towards the home where the Whos lay snooze in their town.
"This is stop number one,"
the old Grinchy Claus hissed as he climbed to the roof, empty bags in his fist. Then he slid down the chimney, a rather tight pinch. But if Santa could do it, then so could the Grinch. Where the little Who's stocking hung all in a row.
Okay. These stockings are the first to go. Ugh.
He slithered and slunk with a smile most unpleasant. Around the whole room, he took every present. Video games, iPhones, stuffies, and drums. As he stuffed all the gifts up the chimney, he smiled with a glee.
"Now," grinned the Grinch, "I will stuff up the tree."
As the Grinch took the tree, as he started to shove, he heard a small sound like the coo of the dove. He turned around fast, and he saw a small Who, little Cindy Lou who was no more than two.
"Santa Claus, why? Why are you not the Christmas tree? Why? Why?"
"There's a light on this tree that won't light up. So, I'm taking it home to my workshop. I'll fix it up there, my dear. Then I'll bring it back here."
And his light fooled the child. He patted her head and gave a little wave, and he sent her to bed. Then he crept to the chimney and stuffed the tree up. Then he slunk to the table. He took the Who's feast. He took the Who pudding. He took the roast beef. It was quarter of dawn. All the Who's still in bed. All the Who's still asleep. When he packed the presents in the sled, 10,000 feet up the side of Mountain Crumpet, he rode with his load to the tip top to dump it. "Hoo, hoo, to the Who's," he was grinchingly humming.
"They're just finding out that no Christmas is coming. They're just waking up. I know just what they'll do. The Who sound whoever will cry, boo hoo. That's a noise that I simply must hear."
And he did hear a sound rising over the snow. It started in low, then it started to grow. Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, was singing without any presents at all. From coming. It came. Somehow or other, it came just the same.
"How could it be so? Christmas came without ribbons. It came without tags. It came without packages, boxes, or bags."
Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before. Maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from the store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more. And what happened then? Well, in Whoville, they say that the Grinch's small heart grew 3 sizes that day. And then the true meaning of Christmas came through, and the Grinch found the strength of 10 Grinches plus 2. And now that his heart didn't feel quite so tight, he whisked with his load through the bright morning light. With a smile to his soul, he descended the Mount Crumpet. He rode into Whoville. He brought back their toys. He brought back presents to the two girls and boys.
Amazing.
Welcome Christmas. Bring your cheer. Cheer to everyone, far and near. Christmas Day will always be just as long as we have.
Welcome Christmas. While we stand heart to heart, and hand in hand.
And they live happily ever after. The end. So, what do you think of the story? Do you like it? Wonderful! I'm glad you like it. Oh, look at what time it is. It's getting late. I think you should go home and get some rest. I should get some sleep too. Well, have a wonderful Christmas and have a wonderful New Year. Bye-bye. Thank you.